built into this plan, they have a waste management programme. I mean, these HMOs are appalling for waste management. If you look at those bins closely enough, the blue one will always be contaminated. The purple ones are left overflow on the front sorter. They may overflow because they've probably been emptied by our guys. But that won't happen once it becomes a HMO. This is the biggest issue I have at the moment with HMOs. I mean, once we get past the bedrooms and bathrooms situation, and this clearly has, and it looks like a good HMO. So no way you can, you know, ask the agent to readdress this or to come back with some sort of thing. But for the money to take in, it takes one day a week to monitor waste management or to bring somebody in to clean it. And I can guarantee that some of our HMOs at the moment are doing just that. The good landlords are actually going around weekly managing the situation. The bad ones, unfortunately, I can show you plenty of pictures. So on this particular one, I'd like to see some commitment to them, if that's okay. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Councillor Sutton. Would Councillor Radford like to come forward?
Thank you, ma'am. I wasn't sure if I'd be able to make it from the licensing committee this morning, but I was able to, so the petitioners are represented, and quite a few petitioners in. There are two specific objections. There's a generic objection that if I may put the first group up. Apart from the red door next door, the property to the right, the property to the left, then skip two houses, the next three properties, and then two of the other properties down the road for all HMOs. The council has declared, I welcome that, Article 4 directive to restrain an excessive area of HMOs in Dales, and we in Stoneycroft think there is every equitable reason why we need the same protection for this part of Stoneycroft. And when I say Stoneycroft, I mean basically Moscow Drive, above the bollards, and Kremlin Drive. There's that many HMOs that has created social instability. One of the other problems that compounds that is obviously the table during the working day. If we take on face value, and I'm saying that for debate purposes, I don't necessarily believe it. If we take on face value, these are professional flats, and believe the applicants will make intent that most people will be working. Apart from the circular bus routes on Queen's Drive, there is no direct bus route in the city centre from Stoneycroft. So the consequence would be, I'm not saying that all the employment is in the city centre, that would be unfair. The predominant route to travel to work areas will require people to have cars, of which there is no space. There is absolutely no, there is no on-site parking. If you've got six households there, you've only got provision for two cars outside. In fairness, the property to the right, the modern one, was previously wasteland. It's a sheltered housing scheme where there was a very serious incident where someone wasn't treated well for an actually committed murder there. They have regular staff 24/7, which is quite appropriate. So there is parking there for probably one of the residents at 131. There's only one car space for residents outside the property of 131. So you've probably got two car spaces for six households. That, I think, is not proportionate to the need. If we take on face value, we're not protesting it, but there's a need for professional flats. There is no parking space there at all. So you've got congestion being compounded there. I don't think that would be responsible by the National Committee. Bear in mind all the other properties in the HMOs. In that immediate 5-minute walk, you have family homes opposite, on to become, there's four family homes opposite,